Hi, the introverted cynist here. Today, I am going to explain a 2003 Danish black comedy film titled The Green Butchers. Warning, spoilers ahead. Kick back and take care. The movie begins in a butcher shop, owned by Holger, a narcissistic exhibitionist, who starts to describe the story of his famous sausages to his customer. Meanwhile, one of his workers, Svend, eavesdrops on Holger boasting about his sausages. Svend is a precarious and gullible butcher, whose parents died when he was a kid, and is yearning to be relevant. Svend discloses, it is not the meat, but his marinade, that actually accentuates the taste of the sausage to his partner, Bjarne, and persuades him to start their very own butcher shop. Bjarne is an inflexible and marijuana-smoking butcher, whose parents and wife died in a car accident 7 years ago. He also has a retarded twin brother, Eigil, who is in a coma due to the accident. Listening to this, Holger barges in and dismisses his marinade theory. Svend informs that he deserves to stand behind the counter and interact with the customers. But Holger says Svend will never do so because he sweats like a pig and is disgusting. Soon after, the duo then meet a realtor, House Hans, who shows them a closed butcher shop. After evaluating the place and the meat freezer, Svend becomes ecstatic and decides to purchase it. However, Bjarne informs Svend that he is short on money, dispiriting him. Later at his apartment, after contemplating on the issue, he decides to meet his brother. Next day, Bjarne pays a visit to the sanatorium, where his brain-dead brother Eigil is being kept alive on machines, and tells nurse Joel to take him off life support because he needs the money he inherited from his parents, to which the nurse agrees, saying it's the best decision for Eigil. Back in the new shop, after purchasing and storing the meat in the freezer, they decide to hire an electrician to fix the lights before the grand reopen. Svend now hands him a couple of business cards to distribute and garner customers. Later, Bjarne visits the cemetery, where his parents and wife are buried. While putting flowers on their tombstone, he meets Astrid, a beautiful orphan girl, who works for Reverend Willemsen at the church and the cemetery. Astrid helps keep the graveyard clean and assists with cremations. After getting acquainted and thanking her for cleaning his family tomb, he invites her to the opening of his shop before getting summoned by the Reverend. On the opening day, they are met with disappointment because there are no customers. Due to this, Svend starts to quarrel with his fiancée, Tina, on trivial issues, such as not to use the free samples and not to use the napkins. Tina becomes outraged towards Sven's attitude and leaves. Later on, the electrician, while listening to music, casually informs that it's very cold inside and steps out to take his coat. Meanwhile, Svend prepares his special marinade and insists Bjarne to taste it. Bjarne becomes a little annoyed and says he will try it later. After an awful day, Svend decides to call it a day and shut shop. Svend now accidentally locks up the electrician, who is busy listening to music in the meat freezer, and leaves. Next day, Tina breaks up with Svend due to his constant obsession about his sausages and his lack of courtship. With a heavy heart, Svend opens the shop, only to witness the dead electrician in the meat freezer. Svend becomes speechless and bewildered. Meanwhile, he listens to the bell ring in the counter, and it happens to be Holger. Holger is actually the first customer in the shop, and he contemptuously says that he is surprised to have stepped into a bustling world of customers. Svend tries to dismiss him, but Holger says that he has the right to be there and is conducting a party in his house with important people. Holger then mocks Svend by calling him Svend Sweat, which provokes Svend to do a senseless deed. Later on, Bjarne receives a call from Svend, informing him about the dead electrician. Upon his arrival, Svend hopelessly hugs Bjarne and starts explaining the ordeal. Bjarne says it's okay and informs him to report to the police as it was an accident. However, Bjarne is surprised to find that the electrician is hung like a meat, with one leg missing. Bjarne becomes unbalanced and curiously inquires about the missing leg. Svend nervously explains that he panicked due to the breakup and the sudden arrival of Holger, which made him cut the leg into fillets and sell it to him. Bjarne realizes that he can't report a dead body with a missing leg, and with no other options, decides to put the body in the bone crusher machine and dispose it, to which Svend agrees. The next day, when Bjarne arrives, a line of patrons stretches outside the door of the shop. Svend's chicky wickies, as he calls the human flesh marinated in his special sauce, are extremely popular. Bjarne becomes furious and confronts Svend. Svend convinces that it does not matter if they dispose the body or sell it, the effect is same. Bjarne advises an emotionally broken Svend that he needs help and instructs him to attend the customers. For the first time, Svend starts smiling and gets great compliments for the special marinated meat. At the end of the day, after selling each and every body part, Svend, now delighted, starts to discuss about their successful day and his special sausages. Bjarne stops Svend to get carried away. Svend now opens up about his life. He reveals that he is an orphan and was bullied and called names when he was little and thought things would be different with Tina, but unfortunately, it didn't. Svend now says that he has never been loved, and what he felt today from the customers was great and fantastic, and furthermore, he wants to maintain it. Bjarne realizes where he is going with this, kicks him. He then instructs him to stop it, saying it's sick and insane. Later on, Bjarne meets Astrid and invites her on a date, and later they share a nice time together in his apartment. Meanwhile, in the shop, Hans drops by because he was in the neighborhood. Svend casually asks if anyone knows he is here, to which Hans says, no. Svend now beckons Hans to the meat locker, describing about the merits, and unapologetically locks him in and leaves. Next day, Bjarne, having a fresh and great night with Astrid, gets complimented by Svend and hands him his new uniform. However, the smile got wiped right off his face after witnessing Hans dead and hung up. After desperately asking him about it, Svend deceives him, saying that he found him dead laying beside the road and took him in. Svend tries to twist it by saying all this happened after meeting Astrid, which is a good sign because now they are successful and famous, and slowly convinces Bjarne to carve him up. Just then, in the sanatorium, Eigil miraculously wakes up, stunning the doctors and the nurses. The following day, Bjarne spots Eigil outside and hides behind the counter quickly and instructs Svend to send him away. After inquiring his visit, Eigil says that he wants to see Bjarne and started throwing tantrums. But Svend, with a straight face, dismisses him. After a couple of to-ing and fro-ing, Eigil hands him a toy of an animal and leaves. Bjarne now meets the nurse and informs her to lock Eigil up because he is retarded. The nurse chastises him for not being responsible enough to take care of his sick brother and says Bjarne is the one who actually needs help. She also adds that she has watched Svend from the TV news and earnestly says Svend is the only person who is sane. This aggravates Bjarne, and he intentionally invites her to the shop to have a chat with Svend. It was then revealed that the nurse has been killed and hung up. Meanwhile, Svend encounters Eigil in the shop, and he scares him away while handing him another toy animal. Later that night, Bjarne and Astrid, sitting on a pier, shares a weird story about the Reverend. Once, the Reverend and his wife, while traveling through a flight on their honeymoon, gets crashed to a mountain, making him the only person to survive. In order to survive, he started eating his wife for a few days until the officials found him almost frozen. Seeing the coincidence, Bjarne refrained himself from sharing any information to Astrid. After departing, Astrid gets introduced to Holger and leaves disinterested. Holger now has an altercation with the success of Svend and Bjarne. The Reverend says, even though he enjoyed their meat, it oddly reminded him of his wife. After listening to this info, Holger starts to feel suspicious. Next day, Astrid meets Eigil, digging at his parents' grave, and gets acquainted with her. Astrid becomes upset at Bjarne for not revealing a sick brother, and later, they become friends. Later that night, Bjarne meets Astrid with a bouquet of flowers, but overhears Eigil's voice with her, making him depart quickly. She then follows him behind, and finally Eigil meets Bjarne. He then slowly approaches Bjarne to hug him, but Bjarne now constantly informs him to stay back. Bjarne then kicks him for not listening and starts walking away. Astrid becomes angry and says to stop acting weird. Bjarne then informs her she does not know what she is talking about and angrily drives off. As a result of their success and fame, Tina visits Svend and tries to make amends. Svend now starts to showboat about his new lifestyle, but Tina shrewdly dismisses it, which then slowly taunts him. While watching the news about the missing case of a couple of people around the neighborhood, Holger feels something fishy and decides to make a call to the poultry distributor. After staring at the sunrise, he goes back to his shop and, without any remorse, helps Svend in cutting up his ex-girlfriend. Later that day, while feeding the chickens with Eigil, the Reverend calls Astrid to his room. Holger reveals to Astrid not to spend time with Bjarne because they have been actually killing people and forbids her to meet him. Having known both Eigil and Bjarne very well, Holger reveals the story of their accident. Several years ago, due to Eigil's illness, his parents always had a soft corner and always let him make every decision. One day, a giraffe was born in a zoo, and Eigil became very adamant to see it, so the family and Bjarne's new wife accompanies them to a road trip. Due to Eigil's eagerness, the parents let him drive. Along the way, Eigil starts to increase the speed of the car, but Bjarne kept insisting Eigil to slow down. Unfortunately, the car flipped and crashed, killing his parents and Bjarne's wife. It was then revealed why Bjarne was cruel to his brother all this time. After hearing this, Astrid accompanies Eigil to visit the butcher shop to meet Bjarne. At the shop, Bjarne decides to leave early. Just then Svend asks Bjarne if he wants to talk about the fight he had with Astrid, but Bjarne just wants to go home and rest. At home he feels troubled and decides to meet Astrid in the church. Later that night, Eigil and Astrid meet Svend to see Bjarne. But Svend dismisses them, saying they shouldn't be here, and uneasily say they shouldn't be with him because he feels sick. But Astrid insists. As a result, Svend escorts them to the meat locker. A moment later, Bjarne arrives and meets the Reverend. He then informs she is not here and dismisses him. At the shop, Svend takes the edge off by listening to music while cleaning the kitchen. It is then shown Astrid and Eigil inside the meat locker, barely alive. Just then, Bjarne barges in and casually asks Svend if Astrid and Eigil have visited the shop. Svend, with a lump in his throat, deceives him. Before leaving, Astrid bangs her head on the door, alerting Bjarne to inspect the locker. He then quickly releases a frantic Astrid from the locker. Svend now casually says it was a joke. Bjarne tries to console her, but she curses them and storms off crying. Bjarne loses his mind and starts to attack Svend. He gets hold of a knife and is about to strike Svend, but Svend begs and runs away. After settling down, Bjarne rescues Eigil from the locker and checks if he is okay. The pair now hold hands, indicating all has been forgiven. Next day, Eigil exits the shop and wander off with a pig head. The following day, while attending the busy customers who are anticipating the Chicky Wickies, gets informed that the meat is over and he can substitute it with chicken. But the customer inquires if the marinade used is the same, to which Bjarne says yes. After getting the chicken from the locker, he finally tastes the marinade and becomes amazed. He then throws in the last palm of the hand to the machine and starts to cut the chicken. Just then, Holger arrives with a couple of men who are from the FDA to search the place and informs the customers to leave. They then inform Bjarne to cooperate with the search because they have received a report that the shop is using unauthorized meat. Seeing the commotion, Svend quickly barges in and starts an emotional wrangle with the officials. Svend now unknowingly starts to confess about the situation and says that Bjarne is innocent and actually Svend is the guilty one. But before Svend could reveal anything more, Bjarne kicks him and pulls him out of the shop. Meanwhile, Holger casually says that they behave this way all the time. The team, after testing the meat, informs that the meat is 100% chicken and nothing else. Holger becomes astonished and becomes a fool in front of the FDA. Outside, while discussing about their future, Bjarne reveals that he tasted the marinade and wholeheartedly says it's actually good, and everyone thinks the same. He says it was the marinade that made the business successful and not the meat, making Svend bring tears of joy. After wandering off, Bjarne escorts Eigil inside, while Svend follows them. After a few days, the trio is seen on the beach. Just then, Astrid arrives and sits beside Bjarne, witnessing Svend and Eigil arguing about the size of their balls. The movie ends with the pair smiling at each other while listening to Svend and Eigil bickering. Thanks for watching. Make sure to like and comment if you enjoyed, and subscribe for more videos.